You're watching GTV on location.
We're at the red carpet premiere for the Outlife TV show.
We're live and direct when we are on the red carpet, baby. And I'm standing here with Amber.
Yep.
And Amber is the director. So Amber, tell us a little bit about what made you think that this was going to be something that you wanted to get involved in.
I was asked to be involved after meeting Cayce on a web series that we worked on together. He and Tonina and myself all worked together. Cayce and I were actors, and Tonina was a production assistant.
Okay.
And Cayce was approached with this idea, and so he started talking to us about it, and it sounded beyond fantastic. I was thrilled. I was thrilled at just thinking about being a part of it. We started doing the casting and such, and then I was kind of bumped up to director. Scared to do it because it was the first time, but I just kind of went with it and had an amazing crew, an amazing cast to go with. It was the best experience I've had so far, just as I've been diving into the acting world and the entertainment world.
Right.
So I couldn't have asked for a better opportunity.
So I got another question for you. This question is, so what do you say to the naysayers that says, okay, this thing has gay people in it, but it's not a man that's directing it?
Interesting. I never thought about it. I'd like to think that I have a very open heart and open mind, and with that, I feel like I can dive into any project that's thrown my way as long as I can look at it with all different points of view and all different ways of thinking.
Exactly.
So I hope that I don't get stereotyped in that way, that it should be a different person directing it, but and hopefully it shows through with my work. But no, I have grown so close to every single person that's a part of this production, and gay, straight, what have you. I hope that I can put the story out there for people to enjoy.
That's what's up. Now, another thing. Tell me in one word, Outlife. What does that mean to you?
One word? Really?
Okay, I'll give you four.
Okay. as far as Outlife, I think it's modern, and as I was saying before, open-minded, and amazing. It's going to touch your hearts, I promise.
So have you seen the whole thing yet? Because I've heard no one else has seen
it. Nobody else, no. Only Tonina and myself.
Only you two. And I'll be meeting her next.
Yes.
So I can't wait to sit down and then talk to you afterwards about what you guys put together.
Absolutely. I can't wait for you to see it.
Thank you again for hanging out with me.
Thank you. It was great meeting you.
You too.
Okay.
We are live and direct. We are on the red carpet out here in Atlanta. You're watching Gay TV. My name is Danilo Ignacio. We'll be right back with a whole lot more.
This show is sponsored by the TV and Video Guide, the best way to watch television on the internet. We're with the cast and crew of the upcoming TV series, Outlife. Gay TV on location.
We're back in the building and we're on the red carpet for Outlife. And we actually have someone that knew the foundation, understood what this was going to be before it became. Tell us who you are.
My name is Tonina Kelly, and I'm the writer for Outlife and Kate Productions.
So how did this come about? How did the whole Outlife thing start?
Well, it did start. Cayce Guest had an idea, and then they actually decided to do a casting and invited me to help with that casting and learned that I was a writer. And so I offered my services. I said, well, you know, if you need me to look over anything. And they said, you know, we don't have a script yet. And I thought, oh. Well, you know, I write.
That's right.
So eventually they kind of handed the reins and trusted almost a complete stranger with it. And, you know, I reported back and gave them my progress and they loved it. So I just went with it and took the characters where I felt they needed to go and develop and actually be likable and someone that people would want to tune in to see every week. And so it was a lot of fun.
And bringing all these characters, how hard was that to really, like, individually write for each one of them and make them shine?
Well, you have to start with a map and a background for each of them. I had to develop a complete life and storyline and a background for each of them and how they intertwine and connect and how they would relate to each other in a salon, in a fun environment anywhere. And so I just went with that and dove into them individually.
Right.
And then as they started to interact with each other, I thought, well, what would Jay do? And what would May Lynn do? And that's just kind of how it unfolded. And, you know, it was hard. And it is hard because I continue to write the episodes and to make sure that I stay true to each of them and what they would do, even the bad decisions. I mean, you know, everybody likes villains too.
Right.
So that's what makes good drama and good comedy. So I have to keep all those things in check and make sure everybody gets some attention. So
when you thought about putting such a diverse show together, as a writer, and of course you want to be able to write it in the whole system of Hollywood, what did you think personally about, okay, what am I stepping into?
Wow. Well, I thought actually it was pretty exciting because only one other pilot that I've written have I dealt with an ensemble cast, but again, it was only four people that I was dealing with as the main characters, and I created them from scratch as well. But with this, I thought, you know, how is this significant compared to other shows that are out there? And I felt it really represents Atlanta's melting pot, and it has such diversity, whether, you know, girls are, you know, heavy set, whether they're really thin, whether they're gay, straight, bisexual, curious, black, white, Hispanic. It just dove into so many different issues, and I thought, this is relevant. It's relevant to Hollywood, it's relevant to Atlanta, it's relevant to America, and anyone who wanted to tune in and watch to see exactly how these people are going to deal with each other. So that's what was so exciting for me.
And I think it was great. Anyone that hasn't seen the trailer, we are running the trailer as we're on the red carpet, so you'll be able to get to see it. And now, how do you think about how people will receive Outlife?
Well, I hope that, you know, there's going to be some great reviews, whether people love to hate a character or they just love to love a character, whether they feel sad for them. There's a whole range of emotions that I really work hard to pull out of people. I want them to get mad. I want them to get happy and everything in between. And I think that definitely touches on that even in the first episode. So I want people to even, like, not like that one character, but they're going to watch, you know, and to see what happens with them. And so people are going to receive it because they're going to be able to relate to somebody in this show.
One word about Outlife.
Crazy.
I think that's a great explanation for it. And we all can't wait to see it. We are on our way inside after this commercial break.
So stay tuned. You have your all-access pass to more conversation and fun as we hang out with the cast and crew of Outlife.
Are you ready to be on location? Stay in the know. Join us, Gay TV On Location.
You're watching Gay TV On Location.
Am I getting a scoop here? Am I getting a little scoop right now about what's going to go on inside? Yeah. What's going to go on?
I'm going to tell you. I'm going to spill the beans. Basically, in a nutshell, it's going to be a good show.
That's all you get.
That's all I get for now.
You just get to see our pretty faces and know that we're there.
Not just us three, but the rest of the other six.
Yeah, all of us.
We have a gorgeous cast.
We do.
So
everyone looks appealing.
In unison, let's let everybody go inside. So we're going to go in 1, 2, 3, Outlife.
Okay.
All right? Ready? In 1, 2, 3,
Outlife.
Sugar Salon, thanks for holding. What do you need?
Maybe being around more gay people will make you feel more comfortable.
Is it really that bad?
Like you've never bothered some poor black girl with a bad relaxer.
What's this like, fool? He's another girl.
Wanna find out?
My name's Eric.
Hi, Eric.
I don't know whether to be mad at you or feel sorry for you.
What is the normal?
What is the normal?
I'm not coming in today.
Excuse me?
So, do we or don't we?
Do we doing what?
The groom.
Honey, I'm a virgin all over you.
You never used to talk to me like that before.
Tonight's show sounds like it's
going to
be a blast.
This is GTV On Location.
This is Outlife on GTV.
That's so different.
Woo!
Yeah, I
right there. You like on your boots? Man, the boots. Take the noise.
From the red carpet to an exclusive conversation with the executive producer director Amber DeVos, writer producer Tonina Kelly, the creator Cayce Guest. So stay tuned, you have your all access pass to more conversation and fun as we hang out with the cast and crew of Outlife.
We'll be right back. We're with the cast and crew of the upcoming TV series, Outlife.
You're watching GTV.
You're watching Gay TV Atlanta.
Welcome to the Dawn.
You're watching
Gay TV Atlanta.
Welcome.